Hello, everyone, and welcome to a very special evening here at the American Library in Paris. Tonight, we are so delighted to be hosting one of our first musical concerts and one of the first events for the festival that we're hosting this month, which we're calling Reverberations. Tonight, it is such a pleasure to be welcoming our inaugural composer in residence and Miss America 2019, Nia Franklin, in concert with Julie Sévilla-Fraysse on the cello and Anastasia Calmus on the piano. Just a brief note about this Reverberations Festival before we begin. This was organized in partnership with the Opéra Comique and with the generous support of the Festival Napa Valley and the Florence Gold Foundation. We are so thrilled to be hosting this festival that celebrates literature out loud. For thousands of years, as long as both have existed, poetic and musical traditions have shaped and informed one another, and this month we are highlighting innovations in the musical arts through a series of concerts, conversations, workshops, and workshops with authors and artists who are coming together to offer a truly synesthetic perspective on the history of storytelling and sound. Tonight, we are welcoming our inaugural composer in residence. Just a brief note about this position. This prestigious residency is granted to trailblazing figures who operate at the intersection of music, literature, the performing arts, and philanthropy. This residency presents an opportunity for composers to explore the rich legacy of artistic connection between France and the United States, and to contribute meaningfully to Franco-American cultural landscape. It's very generously supported by the Florence Gold Foundation and the American Center for Art and Culture. So we are so delighted tonight that our first inaugural composer in residence is Nia Franklin. I'm going to quickly introduce the other musicians first, and then I'll bring Nia on. So first, on the piano, we have Anastasia Calmus. Anastasia was born in Ukraine to a family of artists and then continued her musical education in Moscow at the Nezin State College of Music. She was then accepted to the Moscow Tchaikovsky State Conservatory, from where she graduated with high distinction, and continued her studies at the Conservatory F.A. Bonforti in Italy, earning her master's degree. During this period, she has performed as a soloist at the Orchestra di Trento Conservatory and played solo performances in the United States, Germany, and other locations, and she's lived in France from 2019. So can you join me in welcoming Anastasia, please? Joining us tonight on the cello is Julie Sévilla-Fraysse. After being a core member of the Republican Guard Orchestra and then the Paris Opera Orchestra, Julie Sévilla-Fraysse now dedicates herself to her solo career. Having studied at the Conservatoire de Nice, the Conservatoire National Supérieur de Musique de Paris, and Juilliard, and served as artist in resident at the Queen Elizabeth Music Chapel, Julie has also already played major concerts with the Republican Guard Orchestra, the Toulon Opera Orchestra, and the Philharmonic Orchestra of Morocco. She furthermore plays solo programs around J.S. Bach and folk music. Please join me in welcoming Julie tonight. And finally, last but certainly not at all least, we are so delighted to be welcoming Nia Imani Franklin. Nia is a composer and singer whose music has been performed by the Dallas Symphony Orchestra, Friction Quartet, Saskatoon Symphony Orchestra, Orpheus Chamber Orchestra, and many others. In 2002, Nia was named the inaugural composer in residence for the American Library in Paris, where you are sitting tonight, and she will be performing here tonight this spring. Previous composer-in-residence tenures for Nia include the Music Academy of the West in Santa Barbara, California, and Festival Napa Valley, where she was awarded the Darioush and Shahpar Khaledi Prize for Excellence and Innovation in Classical Music. And in 2019, Nia was also named Miss America. Can you please join me in welcoming Nia tonight?
I've looked in the windows at diamonds. Thank you all so much. It is my pleasure to be here with you tonight and my honor to be here as the inaugural composer in residence. And the first song that we just did was a piece by Kurt Weill, and Langston Hughes wrote the text for that piece. So I wanted to share that with you to start tonight. So as mentioned earlier, I am an American in Paris, and I just got here yesterday, so I'm very excited. It's my first time to be here in Paris, but we're going to give you a wonderful show tonight. And the next piece we're going to do is actually from the first opera that I ever wrote. I'm working on my second one now, but this one I wrote when I was a senior in college. That's when it was premiered at East Carolina University, and it's from the opera I called King Solomon. And this piece is sung by the character Giselle, who it's basically a piece that's based off of King Solomon in the Bible, but I put my own interpretation on it and basically took it into a bit of a fantasy world. So Giselle is the love interest of King Solomon. And so this piece is sung just before she's in antiquity, and she is singing this song all about how much she wants to kiss Solomon. And then she falls asleep. And so you'll kind of hear that at the end of the music, and she wakes up and she's in antiquity time. So it goes from modern day to antiquity. So this is Let Him Kiss Me from my opera, King Solomon.
Let him kiss me with the kisses of his mouth, for your love is better than wine. Your anointing oils are fragrant, your name is oil poured out.
The next song I'm going to perform, we're going to perform, is from one of my favorite operas by one of my favorite composers, Giacomo Puccini, and this is Quantum Invo from La Boheme. I actually performed this song a lot during my career in the pageant world. So the very first pageant that I did in the Miss America system, I performed this song. And it really is one that was with me on my journey throughout the title and the multiple titles finally leading to Miss America. And so this was a song that I performed the night that I won. And so it's always special to me to perform this one.
Mira, e la bella.
piece you will hear is one of my original compositions for solo piano. This is a song that, or a piece that it takes the beginning melody actually from a hymn, which in the Baptist church is hymn number one in most hymn books, Holy, Holy, Holy. And it expands from that melody, but it was really my inspiration for getting the piece started. And then after that, I'm going to perform an R&B song of mine, actually called Runnin', that was off of my first EP. But at this time, we're going to turn it over to Anastasia. So this is a song about heartbreak and running back to someone over and over again that you just can't seem to shake. This is Running.
Sometimes it don't all make no sense. But does that mean we have to call it quits? I know it's not always perfect, but that don't mean it's not worth it. I know I keep letting go, but you know, I just go running, 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 running back to you. And it's just that something, 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 something that you do. I just go running, 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 running back to you. I wish that I could move on. At times all of this feels wrong. Maybe if I had no fear, everything would seem more clear. And when I feel really low, emotions show, and I just go running, 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 running back to you. And it's just that something, 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 something that you do. I just go running, 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 running back to you. I just go running, running, running back to you.
Thank you so much. I'm so happy to have Julie with us tonight, and she is going to perform a piece of mine entitled Sunflower. And this is a really short, sweet piece for cello that I wrote with sunflowers in mind, and about the idea of how they always turn to the light, and just a song to put me in a positive headspace when I was composing it. It was something that, you know, the cello is one of my favorite instruments to write for, so when this was actually my first time writing for solo cello, and so it's just a beautiful sound, and really excited to have it have its Paris debut tonight.
Thank you.
So this is a piece that maybe a lot of people don't know, but it's a piece by Poulenc, and he wrote it for a play for a very specific singer who was French. And so I thought it would be lovely to do this tonight. I first learned it when I performed with Orpheus Chamber Orchestra, which is based in New York, and so that was what helped me to learn about the piece, and so I love performing this now. You can perform it with a specific ensemble that Poulenc wrote for, which included a chamber ensemble of wind instruments and piano, but you can also perform it with just piano. So we're going to perform this, and it's actually called Le Chemin d'Amour.
Oh.
the last selection that we have for you tonight. It's another one that's very close to my heart. I remember performing this right after graduating high school in church, and it was sort of a random last-minute request that I perform, and I had been meditating on this song and hoping for a chance to have a moment to perform it, and the moment came. And so it's a spiritual arranged by Moses Hogan, and it's called Give Me Jesus, and it's a song that is really important to me. My faith is very important to me, and so in dark times, in uncertain times, I feel like this is always a song that I can turn to and reflect on to help get me through anything in life. So this is Give Me Jesus. ¶¶